Hi, this is Martin and welcome back to the Fisher Online. Today, which is Atlantic cod, very common fish here. This is the best of the Norway, I think, but very tasty fish. So yeah, why not to do an episode about this fish? And this fish there is a daily quest for this fish, so yeah. Okay, from the beginning, let's say, maybe I will throw this rod here. Some player catch a trophy, Merluzzo. From the beginning, yeah. You can catch this fish everywhere here. Everywhere. And I mean everywhere, because this fish is biting in the this not so deep areas. It's biting in the ocean. Yeah, it's a sea fish, so you'll be catching this fish pretty much everywhere. Yeah, 25 meters. So, the best spot, the easiest one, like always, is this spot here. You can catch this Atlantic cod here, yeah, like I said, in entire this waters from Norway, I was catching this Atlantic cod here, which is most common place, standard place. But you will be catching a lot of Merluzzo, a lot of Turbots, lots of Haddock, what more it was. The other fishes you can catch in this place, yeah, pretty much every fish. Sable fish at night, you can catch Atlantic salmon, Coley, Arctic char, just depends from the baits you are using. You can catch Turbot, Halibut, so yeah, you can catch in this place, standard place. This is a quadrant I-4, so yeah, you can catch this Atlantic cod here. You just put your boat or whatever here, and you are casting this way, this northeast direction. Even two bites, my hipnet is pretty much full at this point. So yeah, I think this will be one of the last fishes for me here, for this Atlantic cod. Yeah, this is my lighter setup. As well, I was checking just all options. Yeah, a flounder. So yeah. Ah, flounder you can catch as well. So yeah, good that I fished it, because I forgot about this fish. So you can catch even a flounder in this let's say standard place for this fish. What is this? Another flounder. Okay, we'll be not casting this anymore. Other place where I was catching this fish, I was here somewhere over here. I don't remember the exact place. It was K9, let's say K8, or it was I-9. I was even catching it here in G7. So yeah, this entire area in this 25 meters deep, this I don't know, this like a channel here, so you can catch this fish here. So yeah, you can catch it everywhere in the Norway. Time this fish is biting all day long, so yeah, at daytime, nighttime, so doesn't matter for this fish. Maybe before I will be reeling this, maybe let's cut some some fishes, this flounders, this a couple of haddocks, coley. Like you can see, couple of this Atlantic cods I have. So yeah, you can catch this this fish all day long, all night. It's biting. Maybe at night it's not biting as good as at the daytime, but it's biting. The thing is, at night time you will be catching a lot of sablefish. Sablefish. What more it was? I think it was a coley as well. So yeah, like you can see. Nearly half past 2 a.m. and you can catch this Atlantic cod. Pretty much I wasted this a bunch of fish meat, but yeah, okay. So yeah, time doesn't, this fish doesn't matter. My rods, I have this light setup, let's say 20 kilograms with 19 kilograms leader, but I think leader is not important. I was catching this fish without a leader, same as ground bait, this krill. I was catching this fish without this ground bait hooks. Hooks you can use number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4 even. But when I was fishing in this place here, for example, you can expect on hook number 3, number 4, you can expect that you can bite this bait, which I was using. It was a bunch of fish meat, can bite a shark. So you will need a good strong setup, for example, like this one. It's not a, yeah, it's not fantastic, but you can catch a shark on this setup. I catched one of 41 kilograms, but I was using this other boat, not this one, because this one is just for fishing this fishes, which you can reel with your rod. If you want to catch the bigger ones, you need to have this this boat, because I believe on this boat you can't take a rod now, like it was before. So yeah, just yeah, it's, this boat is useless to catch a fish and to go after this fish with boat. So yeah, and it has holes like all the boats. And you, some, like you can see a water. But yeah, anyway. So yeah, prepare pretty good rods, because this fish, this Atlantic cod, can be pretty big. It's this max weight. I don't know why this is around 10 kilograms. This max weight. So yeah, it should be changed to other number, let's say, because like you can see on the records, someone a player Hamma 42 catched Atlantic cod, which is 62 and nearly 63 kilograms. So yeah, on a spinner. I didn't have much luck on the spinner, but yeah, he catched it or she catched it. So yeah, the baits, because there is not too much to talk about. Like you can see, here is without leader. I was catching on this rod this Atlantic cod as well. But let's go to the baits. The baits for this fish. For me, this is my opinion. For me, the best bait for this fish, it was a bunch of fish meat. Yeah, you can use fish pieces, but for me, like I said, for me the best was bunch of fish meat. Bunch of fish meat, but when you are fishing in this deeper areas, let's say in the open sea. For me to catch this fish in this standard spot, let's say, it was a waste of time because many times you will be catching on this bunch of fish meat. You will be catching a lot of time Atlantic salmon, merluzzo, so yeah. For me, it's just waste of resources to catch this Atlantic cod in this standard place. So normally I was using this bait in the open sea. Sometimes you can catch a shark, but it's a fun fishing, this shark fishing, let's say. Other baits I was using, it was a shrimp, but not too much luck on this. Other ones, very good baits for this Atlantic cod, it's a sea worm and a nereis. And these two are working very well in this place I4. When you are here, you can cast on hook number 2, because on 1 you will be catching a lot of stuff, a lot of fishes, different fishes. Hook number 2 for me was the best one. On nereis especially, I think on haddock, on seaworm, I had a lot of haddocks. You can catch this fish, of course, on fish pieces, like I said before. I was catching sometimes on bait fish, but bait fish, of course, it's a and sea live bait. For me, many times I had Atlantic salmon, same as on a bunch of meat. If I was fishing in this place. So I like to use this bait fish or sea live bait on the open sea. So from the spinning lures, I was catching most of them on this VIP MD Cyclop M3 or M1, whatever. This is just for me. Day after day is one of the best lure in the game. You can catch it, of course, this Atlantic cod on ACMA 4x4B1 gold. I was catching this, but yeah, my keep net is not so big, so I needed to go, I don't know, many times to the shop to fish trader to sell this fishes. You can catch this Atlantic cod, of course, on this fear spinner bait. It's a New Year spinner, so yeah, let's forget about it. On VIP salmon, this series, the best for me, of course, like always, it was GT2, this red one. You can catch there is a record now on CRL DGM, CRL DG, let's say, series. I catched, I think, one, and it wasn't too big, so yeah, but I catch on this one, this M1. Like you could see before, the record is on one of this. You can catch this fish, of course, on the on this this jigs, let's say, but I don't know. For me, it wasn't working the best, so yeah. Same as wobblers. The best one, yeah, it was this wob deep tail series. So yeah, you can try on this one. I just don't like. It's not I don't like. It's just I don't have a rod good enough to fish on the wobblers on this one especially. So yeah, because my best casting spinning rod, I have a spinning rod, it's just 30 kilograms. So yeah, and I think I didn't forget about anything. Let's go fast, of course, to the shop to check the prices for this fish. Experience, I don't remember it was good or not. I think for this green ones, it was kind of 1,300 or so. So 1,100 for a green one. For the blue one, I don't remember. Pretty don't remember how much it was. Okay, these are the fishes I catched. Like I said, it's not. I don't think it's because it was 75 kilograms, so I don't think there is a 75 here because I needed to sell a couple of them. Like you can see, bunch of fish meat, bunch of fish meat, cyclop, M3, nereis, sea worm, nereis, and this was for me the best baits, the best lure. For this fish, let's check the prices of this Atlantic cod, and yeah, the prices for this fish, for the price to the weight, it's not good, but it's a very common fish, so yeah, you can expect that this will be on that this way. For the blue ones, you can expect it will be $5.36 for a kilogram, so it's a very bad result. And for a green one, it's around $3.50 for a kilogram. So yeah, it's a very very bad result for this fish. It's just you can catch this fish everywhere, and it's a very very common fish. You can catch it on pretty much every bait you cast. You can catch this fish. So yeah, let's sell all of them. My was worth 380 for a couple of them. It's how many? 15. Yeah, 15 fishes. So it's not a. Let's sell this fishes. So and flounder, 380 for 89 kilograms. So it's a very very bad result. Like I said, it's just this fish is. If you are using this fish meat and you don't need to buy it from the auction house, even yeah, it's not the not the you don't you will not be spending a lot on this bait, but 70 even this 75 for this fish, it's just yeah, not worth 11 kilograms of this fish. It's not worth what you will be winning to fish this fish. If you are crafting this bunch of fish meat, yeah, you have pretty much $59. You're just spending a couple of cents on this PVA material, and yeah, this way is a lot of better than buy this bunch of fish meat from the auction house. So yeah, okay, I think I didn't forget about anything about this fish, because yeah, it's a common fish, not worth a lot. So yeah, pretty easy quest, just need the time which I don't have lately. In last 2 days I didn't have too much time to make a video, but I just sit a little bit and I catched all of this Atlantic cods. So yeah, it's not a hard quest. Like, dislike and subscribe, of course. Thanks everyone for watching, and I see you in the next one. See ya.